In previous videos, we have discussed five traits of a professional, and one of them was critical thinking. The link will be in the description. Today we are going to talk about the application of critical thinking to reading and processing information flows. This is extremely important because professionals work with huge amounts of data. If they don't use filters, they will collect huge amounts of trash. So let's talk about information filters and critical reading. There are three groups of parameters to be considered. The first group is a source or author evaluation. The first point is competency in the topic you are interested in. Anyone can easily imagine a physicist who wrote an article on political issues, but he or she is not an expert in politics, and we cannot consider such an article as a reliable source of information. The second point is the following. Does the source have common mistakes, mistaken premises, or popular simplifications? To check it up, I recommend you to open any chapter on your best-known topic. For example, if the author recommends split training to a gym newcomer, it means that he or she is not a reliable fitness coach. Split training is not a fatal error, but it's not an optimum. As a reader, I propose that there could be similar inaccuracies in other chapters too. Thirdly, it's a primary source and first-hand information, or it is just an implementation. A secondary source, a tertiary source. There is even a stricter criterion. Does the author have examples of personally solved problems? It's a widespread situation in business literature when an author has only imaginary examples. Imaginary cases like, let's imagine an average customer. And good business books with examples of solved business problems are quite rare. Indeed, personal, professional experience and experience on solving problems is the most valuable source material. A good example is developers' diaries and blogs describing a whole history of solving a problem step by step. The final point here is fulfilling scientific principles, methodology and ethics. It means to make correct references to primary sources, to make a distinction between facts, hypotheses and verified methods, to give details and specifications for different inputs, and to mention limits for the application of recommendations and methods, to point out exceptions, etc. The second group is data evaluation. The first point here is objectivity. Can the data be verified objectively? There shouldn't be any emotions, personal opinions, declarations, slogans, dramatizations, abuses, and so forth. All these elements make the data subjective and unverifiable. The second point is whether data include the transformation of a situation in detailed actions or not. In other words, is the piece of information source material with a causal link or not? We discussed terms source material and causal link in the previous video. Links are in the description. The third point is an argumentation. What arguments does the author propose? Argumentation is one of the major attributes of knowledge. If a thesis has no arguments, it's just an opinion. The final point. Whether I have a simple counterexample or not. Sometimes it's easy to find a simple counterexample to the author's statement. For example, if the author says that there are two types of managers, democratic and dictator-like. You can easily remember managers that were democratic in some ways and dictator-like in others, because of the reaction to specific situations. The third group is an applicability evaluation. The first point here is novelty. A piece of information should have non-obvious consequences. If it is obvious for a student, it's not a valuable source for the professional. The idea that you need to promote your website or to know your audience is obvious. The matter is in non-trivial techniques, specific ideas of positioning and standing out. The second point is repeatability. Is it possible to repeat the transformation step by step with the same result? If the result is sustainable, similar actions lead to similar results. The final point is adequate costs. Surely, if you want to relax after hard work, you can go to a spa and have a massage. But can you do that every day? Is it an optimal way to relax? How much does it cost? Ideally, the recommendation should be resource-based. It means that you already have everything to implement the recommendation. So, critical reading allows professionals to expose the most useful and reliable information and eliminate all the rest. It's an important filter for big information flows that professionals work with. And the good quality of collected techniques leads to better results. If you want to know more about professional development principles and strategies, check out the other videos on the channel and wait for the new videos. Thank you.